Pete to the Pedalprof Name Chart. This video is part of the basic series, and this one is about importing a PDF file so you can keep track of your progress. Let's start by creating a new project again, selecting the plus button here. This time select import a PDF or a photo, tap next. Here you have a few options. You can select a PDF, you can also select a photo from your photo library, or you can, for instance, use the camera if you want to take a picture of a magazine or a book, for instance. Or you can import a file from your Reverie account. Let's start by just selecting a PDF from my files. When you import a PDF, it will always start with two default rulers, one vertical and one horizontal. If you have the Move tool selected in the center, you can drag them around to mark the row you're currently working on. You can change the way these rulers look by tapping and holding on one, and then, for instance, tapping size and decreasing it a bit. You can also change the color or add an extra ruler to the chart. Let's take a look at the available tools. On the bottom left, you can open up the row counters. You can tap and hold on one if you want some extra options like the name or change the color and stuff like that. This is just for toggling on and off the thumbnails, like this, if you need some more space. This is for writing something on your chart. This is for marking a portion, so it could be handy if you're working with text, for instance. This is to move stuff around, so this could be for moving objects, the rulers, or even if you tap and hold on the PDF, you can place a highlight like this. And then you can use it to move it around. For instance, if you want to mark a stitch. Again, if you tap and hold on this, you can change the color or change the size of the marker. The next tool has a few options. The first one is to cut out a portion of your PDF and then save that as an image. Or you can also cut out a portion and then create a new chart from it. This is just to place a text box onto your PDF, and this is to place a rectangle. You can use the eraser to erase drawn elements on your PDF page like this, and this is just to change the current color. On the top left you have the settings. For instance, you can choose to show the PDF with two pages next to each other. This can make it easier if you have a very large document with a lot of pages and you would just want to like quickly scroll through them. You have some more options here, and again this is undo, redo, and zoom out. So that's it. These are the most important features when working with the PDF file in Knitting Chart.